right. So hello, welcome to DE History. I have to make a video for those parents who couldn't be here. And then I thought, well, why don't I just make this video and put it on Schoology so you all have it. So this is DE History. This is DE World 2. So it is the equivalent of two college semester classes. This you'll be taking, the students start with History 112, which is world history post 1500 to present. That will go from now until the end of second quarter. And then in the second quarter, in the spring, they will do their second semester, which is Western civilization. So when you look at the syllabus, you'll see it's divided. So while it will be one grade book for FCPS, it will be two grades because it's two college classes and six credits, which I know you guys are in the DE world. Who is this person? I probably should have introduced myself. I am Mary Catherine Keating. Just real quick, I'm gonna just go through. Been teaching 31 years. I am a Pennsylvania girl, hoping to get back to Pennsylvania. In fact, I will be going to Gettysburg this weekend. This is my second year teaching DE. I have taught, I always say I'm a 1900s teacher. I've been teaching since the last century. When I went in, there was no technology in the classroom. And I've been at Chantilly for 20 years, and I've been teaching in the county for 24, and I've taught World 2 every year in the county. So World 2 is my jam. All right, so big things, supply list. Students, we will be doing our notes by hand. I've done the research, I've read the research, hand notes over computer notes, we'll be doing a lot. I do focus notes, Cornell notes, things of that nature. So we're just going to put it in one place. Best thing is spiral notebook. You want 8.5 by 11 or bigger. If you get college ruled, don't get wide ruled, because then they have to cut and paste and we don't want to cut and paste. And everything, so by the end of the year, they'll have a textbook. Everything will be in there. With the new cell phone policy, if you can get them, headphones that connect to the computer, so have the cord. I go to the dollar store and buy a whole bunch, but then they walk away. The reason is if we're doing something in class and they want some independent work or we're doing a video, because sometimes I'll give kids a choice where we can watch the video together, but some kids, it's better if they do it independent and slow it down. But the headphones, I'm going to make sure they're connected to the computer. So this isn't really big, but the big thing is to understand there are two grade books in this class because your students are Chantilly students and they are Nova students. SCPS grade book has A minuses, B pluses, B minuses, etc. The Nova grade book is A, B, C, D. So Nova grade book, Nova grade scale is 0 to 100. Chantilly grade school scale is 50 to 100. So, for example, a student does not complete an assignment. It goes in the Nova grade book as a 0, it goes into the Chantilly grade book as a 50. Because the lowest you can get in Chantilly, the two different grade scales. Questions on that? Okay. I put this in. So there's two grade books because of the different, and on the syllabus has the Nova policies, you've got the Chantilly policies. So, and I spelled major wrong. Retakes, I'll give you a perfect example of how it works. Student comes in, takes a test, summative assessment, scores an 85%, let's say. In the FCPS grade book, I'll put an 85%. In the Nova grade book, I'll put an 85%. They choose to retake, the Nova grade remains an 85%. Let's say they got a 95 on the retake, the 95 goes in the FCPS grade book. So the Nova grade and the FCPS grade will be different. Once the grade book is up and running, the students will log into Canva to see their Nova grade book. So just wanted to go over that. They will receive a grade for both their 112 and 102, and then you can check the syllabus for the NOVA grade policies. I'm going to tell you right now, I'm going to do everything to make sure your kids are successful. My goal with this class is these kids are taking a college class. I'm getting them prepared. They're getting their college history class done. But this may be the only time, like a lot of these kids, when they graduate high school, are never taking history again. My goal is one, they don't hate it. Because a lot of them come in and they hate it. I'm not going to, I have the advantage, I have six more additional weeks than AP. So we've got a time to dig in and we've got a time to really learn history and enjoy history. They will be doing a lot of research in this class. They will be doing a lot of writing in this class. My goal is that we will write every day. Now, when I say we're writing every day, we're not writing an essay every day. We're also going to be looking at, like in the spring, their research project was a podcast. So we'll have some traditional, like in the winter, we do a traditional college essay research paper, 3 to 5 pages. Because this is also a 100-level class. It is not a 300-level history class. So, and then in the spring. But again, unlike college, like on the first day, they're like, oh, the paper's due at the end of the semester. Well, here's what's going to happen with me. Okay, we're going to have a research paper. You're going to go to the library. This is due on this day. This is due on this day. This is due on this day. One of the things I do require in all my projects is we need Fairfax County place for varsity tutor. So, like, for example, if you have a paper that you have to submit to me, part of the assignment will be you have to submit it to Varsity Tutor to get, we're paying for it, we might as well use it. So things like that. Two grade books, their drop dates, you'll see, these are the drop dates. The drop date is for September 12th. Nothing goes on the NOVA transcript. If they withdraw 11/24, a withdrawal will go, so a W will go, but it will not affect their grade for NOVA. The only thing you want to make sure is if your students are taking DE, let's say they sign up for, before they graduate, they sign up for 12 DE classes and they withdraw, and they have 12 W's on their college transcript. NOVA just wants you to be aware that that could interfere with college financial aid. But I find that students, we work together. We work together. I will tell you, like I said, grades may be lower at the beginning, but I work to get them. I want them to get where they need to be. Student, the big thing, two big things, I think. So this slideshow, I'm not going to go through this slideshow because I don't know how much time I have left, and I just really want to just take big things. Big thing with attendance, if students are absent on the day of the test, the day they return, they take the test the next day. If students are absent the class before the test, they come in the next day, they take the test. Now, if there are extenuating circumstances,
Head to your child's
and so
period class.
Just contact